स्टूडेंट्स, आई वेलकम यू ऑल वंस अगेन टू द ई लर्निंग सेशंस ऑफ ऑटोमोबाइल इंजीनियरिंग. माई सेल्फ हार्दिक शाह, एंड ड्यूरिंग दिस लेक्चर सीरीज वी विल डिस्कस सम इंटरेस्टिंग टॉपिक्स इन द सब्जेक्ट ऑफ ऑटोमोटिव इलेक्ट्रिकल्स एंड इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स. फाइन, वी आर स्टार्टिंग अ न्यू चैप्टर टूडे, दैट इज लाइटिंग सिस्टम्स. एंड अवर टूडेज टॉपिक इन दिस वीडियो इज बेसिक्स ऑफ लाइटिंग सिस्टम इन ऑटोमोबाइल. ओके, आई होप you will see this video till the end to completely understand this topic and gain your skills in automobile engineering. I request you also to note down any queries which arises during the lecture, okay, and ask it in comment section. I will try to solve all the queries as soon as possible. Fine, so now let's start our today's video about the lighting system. So let's see first introduction of this chapter. So as we all know, automotive lighting is one major aspect of any car. Lights can take any car from 0 to 100 very quickly, okay, with this help. So however, these lights aren't something simple. A single look at the car's headlight can change the overall perception of the car, okay. Moreover, it's not just about the practical use, but it gives the car a character, and it's very important in designing the front look of the vehicle, okay. Also, the automotive lighting circuits include important safety features, so they must be properly understood and serviced according to it, okay. So lighting circuits follow general patterns according to the devices they serve, okay. Although slight variations appear from manufacturer to manufacturer in designing of the different lights, okay. So with new technologies coming in every day, the cars are surely going to get better day by day, okay. While automotive lighting has come a long way since the inception of all the cars, okay. So we have seen many modifications, okay. So now let's discuss about the lighting system of the vehicle. So the lighting system of the motor vehicle consists of lighting and signaling devices which are mounted or integrated in front, rear, sides, and in some cases on the top of the motor vehicle. Okay, so the lights, what it does, so the light is a roadway for the driver and increases the visibility of the vehicle and allowing the other drivers and pedestrians to see the vehicle's presence, position, size, therefore direction of the travel, the driver's intention regarding the direction and speed of the travel. Okay, some emergency vehicles usually carry distinctive lights equipment to warn other drivers and indicate the priority of the movement in the traffic, that is also served by lighting. Okay, so various lights of the vehicle have specific functions to either help the driver or to signal to other drivers. Okay, so when used improperly, accidents can happen. So this is why it is extremely important to be able to recognize the different types of lamps and know when to use them. Okay, so let's see all these lamps in very brief. First is headlight. There are two types of headlights, low beam and high beam. Okay, deeper and simple. Okay, now these lights allow the driver to see the roadways in the dark while also signaling to other motorists that car is present. Okay, now low beam provide a light distribution to give adequate forward and lateral illumination without blinding other road users with excessive glare. Okay, high beam provides the intense center weighted distribution of the light with no particular control of the glare and should be only used when there are no visible car in front of you, okay, either coming either going. Fine, so we will see this in further detail about the headlights. Okay, next is tail lights. So tail lights are required to produce only red light at the rear of the vehicle, and they are wired such that they are light whenever the headlights are on. Okay, this helps driver who are traveling behind you to recognize that you are there in front and how much you are ahead from them. Okay, next is daytime running lights. What is that? These lights are located in both the front and the rear of the car and generally turn on the automatically, although in some cars you do not have an option to turn them off. Okay, Now they are designed to make you more visible to the other vehicles, but some drivers find them distracting in oncoming cars. Okay. Next is fog lights. So what is that? Now it is located near the headlights. Now these lights and the are generally mounted low in order to prevent the light from the refracting on the fog and glaring the back towards to you. Okay, towards driver. So these should only be used during the fog when normal headlights are not very effective. Okay. Next is signal lights, or you can say indicators. It is also known as the blinkers, which are located in the front and the back of the car, sometimes besides the headlight and the tail light. Okay, so when activated, they indicate to other drivers that you will soon be turning, means in indicated direction of the signal, and it will most likely be slowing down to do so. Fine. Next is brake lights. What is that? So they are located to the side of your rear lights. They signal drivers that you are slowing down or stopping. Okay. Now since there are only activated when you apply the brakes, you don't need to worry about the misusing them. Okay. However, you do have to make sure that they are properly maintained and do not burn out, so it will be easy for you during the accidents also. Next is hazard lights. It is also known as flashers. They are located in front and back of the vehicle. Now when they are turned on, they are emitting a flashing signal to warn other drivers that you are experiencing a problem, are in distress, or warning of the immediate danger, that is the rocks in the road, slow front procession, right? So they should only be used as a warning of the distress or traffic problems. Never use it as a stop signal or illegal parking permits. Okay. Next is driving lamps. What is that? So these are located inside the cab of your vehicle, and they are used to brighten the cab for the passenger or driver to safely check maps or directions or locate different items in the dark. Okay. They should never be used for the long period which are inside your car. Okay. So this was the introduction of all the major lights that we will use in a vehicle. Okay. And we will see it in some of the next lectures. Fine. Now let's see what is the headlamp and headlamp circuit. The headlamp circuit is one of the most standardized automotive circuit, because headlamps use is regulated by laws, and that until recently had little changes from some years. Okay. Now there are two basic types of the headlamp circuits. First is two lamp circuit, second is four lamp circuits. Okay, two lamp circuit, four lamp circuit. Okay, manufacturers select the type of circuit on the basis of automotive body styling. Okay, each circuit must provide a high beam and a low beam light, a switch or switches to control the beams, and a high beam indicator. Okay, so this was about the types. Now let's see about the circuit diagram of this headlamp. Most often the headlamps are grounded and switches are installed between the lamp and the power source, that means the battery or alternator. Okay. Some circuits have insulated bulbs and their grounded switch. Okay. In both cases, all the lamp filaments are connected in parallel. The failure of one filament will not affect current flow through the other filaments. Okay. So a two lamp circuit uses lamps that contains both a high lamp and low lamp filament. Okay. And a four lamp circuit has two double filament lamp and two lamps with a single filaments. Okay. Which are high beam filaments. Fine. So this was about the basics of headlamp circuit and simple components inside it. Okay. We will see it in detail in next session. Fine. So we have discussed about the basic lighting systems, different types of lights and its purpose. Okay. I wish you got all the clear idea about this. Therefore, if you have any more to know or any have a specific query, please let me know. I will surely try to respond as soon as possible. Okay. In the next lectures, we will discuss about the headlamp circuit operations in detail and about the different lights. Okay. I hope you like this video. Thank you so much. Stay tuned. Goodbye.